everyone, welcome back to Kung Fu Piano. Today we are going to talk about the mechanical aspect of playing piano, and that's where the real Kung Fu is taking place. A lot of people think that playing fast is really hard, but that's not true. With proper training, it's actually really easy. In order to play fast, your hands have to acquire this magical Kung Fu state, where two different polarities meet each other, tense and relaxed at the same time. When you watch any good martial artist move, you can see that he is completely relaxed, while his kicks and punches are lethal. So how do you achieve this state? I'm about to share this amazing method with you that I personally learned from one of the greatest teachers on the planet, Tamara Afanasyevna Popovich. I call it stops. The majority of fast passages usually consist of groups of four or three, and what we are going to do is stop on every note of each group. Even if we have a seamless passage, it could be still divided into these groups, and this method could be applied. Let's take a short arpeggio as our first example because it is a very apparent group of four. So let's stop on every first note of the group of four, and while on the resting note, let's relax our wrist, our elbow, and our shoulder. Let's really raise our fingers and hit hard on the remaining notes until the next stop of the next resting note. Don't confuse raising your fingers with this move. Don't compensate for the absence of this with your wrist. It's very important to know that the amplitude of this move gets smaller as the tempo gets faster. So if you start with this much, in a faster tempo it would be this small, but still there. That's where the speed comes from. With this in mind, let's stop on every second note of the group now, and then stop on every third and fourth note of the group. Normally, the wrist movement would have to be programmed separately, but we can do that while stopping on the fourth note of the group. Remember that you have to exaggerate every move in a slower tempo, because then the move that you're programming will be smaller in a faster tempo, but still there. Also, try not to lose the strength in your fingers. Make sure the fingering remains as written. It is very important. Pay attention to what you are actually programming. So what's happening is we are teaching our fingers and our wrist to be relaxed and tense at the same time on every note of the group. So the next step is to raise the tempo, and if it looks like this, then the next step would be to do the groups of eight and stop on every first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth note of the group. and if you did everything right. Let's look at this descending passage that I took from Chopin's Etude No. 12. It's a little bit trickier than the short arpeggio. And let's work on the wrist movement. Of course, this method could be applied for both hands. In order not to make this video too long, let's skip the groups of eight and move on to the triplets. This Oscar Peterson passage would be a good example. This time, let's take the group of six. The next step is to do the groups of 12, but to keep this video reasonably short, we can skip this for now, and you could try it on your own. I think you got the point by now. Yes, it seems time-consuming, but in reality it saves several weeks to learn something in comparison to other methods. Memorizing the passages happens a lot faster, and your muscle memory gets programmed really well, to the point where your hands know what to do better than you. There are two main points that you must remember about. First one, you absolutely have to keep the fingering throughout the whole exercise as written. If you play different fingering every now and then, it will not work. To really program it well, the fingering has to remain the same. Second point, you have to exaggerate every move. If you don't raise your fingers high enough in a slower tempo, the strength in the fingers will remain insufficient to play at faster tempos. So exaggeration is very important. Even though the principle seems simple enough, my experience shows me that you would need some further guidance until those beneficial habits are fully developed. So go to my website, check out my videos, and book your first lesson.